Hello guys, welcome. In our last section, we discussed about how to upload a zip file, create a directory or a folder, get the content of that zip file, delete that zip file and redirect to add-on manager page. In this section, guys, we want to start to work with the payment gateway. Don't forget, I said we want to build an add-on, okay? But we need to add more features, but in form of an add-on. So I am going to use Paystack Payment Gateway as an add-on. So assuming you have sold this software to your client and you have only integrated PayPal Payment Gateway, all right? But you want to add more features and you want your client to purchase that feature. So we are going to create a new features, a new payment gateway, Paystack. All right. And when the user, your client, purchase that add-on from you, we want the client to be able to click on add-on manager, browse that zip file, click on install, set up the necessary tables and upload the necessary files. Alright, so let's get started. The first thing is that I need to create an invoice for the student. Okay, actually this is not compulsory, but I want to show you something. Let's say the amount is $5,000, payment status unpaid, and the payment method, we want to use card. So I'm going to click on create an invoice. Alright, so not compulsory you have the software, but just understand the logic and the flow. Beautiful. So let's log out from the admin portal. I want to log into the student portal. Login. Let's see what we got there. So I'm going to click on an invoice. Beautiful. So we have an invoice of $5,000. You have not paid any amount. Your balance is $5,000. Beautiful. So I think you should process that on your own software. So which means the student could pay via PayPal payment gateway. So this has been integrated. So we want to write a code now that when the administrator install, purchase the new add-on, which is the Paystack payment gateway, install that add-on and the installation is successful, we want another button to appear here for student that pay via Paystack. Do you get the logic? So good. So which means that we are going to work inside this invoice. You know, initially your client who purchased this software from you have access to this invoiced file, but in our add-on we are going to work inside this invoiced file. Okay, so which means that when they are installing the add-on, we need to replace this invoiced file so that we can have our Paystack button here. Okay, so which means we need to work with this update config.json. Don't forget, I said from the previous video that the function of this file is to find, to create and replace. Okay, so which means that we are going to replace this invoice during the process of add-on installation. Hope you are getting it. Good. So guys, another thing is that we need to work with the admin portal. So I want us to log into the admin portal 1234. I want to show you something. I just want you to get the concept. I'm sorry about the noise. So let's continue. I want to go to system settings, general settings. Beautiful. So when the administrator purchased the add-on, install the add-on and the installation is successful, we want to automatically get another text feed here asking us to type Paystack secret key. Okay, you know, you have to go to Paystack website, register, you are going to get Paystack secret key. So we need that secret key to process our payment gateway, to facilitate the payment system using Paystack. So which means once you install the add-on, okay, let me open this in another tab. I want you to get the concept. By the time you purchase the add-on, install the add-on, and it is successful, we want automatically to display a text feed here requesting for Paystack secret key. Alright, that's point number one. Point number two, in student page, in invoice file, in the invoice page, we want another button to occur there that pay via Paystack. Beautiful. So which means we are going to work inside this file, system settings, and in student page we are also going to work there, invoice file. Okay, so which means we need to work in two files. Another thing is that we need to create a table. Don't forget that this system settings has a table where all the school settings are kept. All right, so we want to automatically create another column inside that system settings table for Paystack. So during the process of add-on installation, all these would be taken care of, and those are the things that we want to do. So before we start to work with our script, we need to back up two files. We are going to back up system settings file and invoice file in student page. All right, so after that we are going to keep them somewhere. We are going to process our new code. After we have done with the add-on, we are going to extract those new files, zip them, okay, and return the old files, return them back, because your user, of course, they will have access to the old files. It is until when they purchase the add-on, install that add-on, that is when they can have access to the new files. Okay, good. So guys, in the next video I am going to introduce you to the Paystack API so that you can see what we want to implement. Okay, so thank you. See you in the next tutorial. Bye.